Israel's domestic economy has been outperforming other developed countries, but the third quarter showed it's far from immune to global problems. Israeli companies listed in the U.S. posted their biggest quarterly loss on record. Their stocks fell 21%, and that's the worst performance since Bloomberg began collating the data back in August of 2005. Now, leading those losses were technology firms Allot Communications and Internet Gold Golden Lines, both of which fell by more than 45%. While analysts attributed the declines to concerns over a potential global recession and worsening political risk in the Middle East. And while Israel's domestic stock markets didn't fall as far, it was still its worst quarter since June of 2010. Now, Tel Aviv's benchmark index fell some 12% during the period and dropped further still in Sunday trading. Well, for more on this, let's go live to the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange to speak to Neil Corney. He's treasurer at Citibank Israel. Neil, thank you so much for joining us on the program. How concerned are you by the fact that actually a lot of these Israeli stocks listed in the U.S. fell more than a lot of the U.S. stocks? Because, of course, you're an economy that's skewed to a lot of European and U.S. exports.
Absolutely. Obviously, We believe that it's mainly connected to the general market malaise, and in general the failure of emerging markets to perform well. If you have a look, though, the Israeli market is down roughly 20% this year, which is in line with Europe. And being that a lot of the stocks are duly listed and duly traded, there's no real surprise that the stocks in Israel are down about 20%, even though the rest of the U.S. market is only down 10%.
And so are we going to see a lot more volatility, Neil, in the coming months because of the way that actually the Israeli economy is skewed?
I think that's going to very much depend on the world growth story. Israel, as you know, is very much dependent on its export sector. It's almost 40% of GDP. And if there is indeed a general slowdown in world growth, then without doubt that is going to affect the Israeli economy, that is going to affect Israeli growth, and subsequently that will affect Israeli companies.
Now, of course, the industry groups, in terms of some of them in Israel, are doing much better than the rest of the world. And I'm thinking of banks and financial stocks.
Yes, absolutely. You know, the banking sector is trading roughly 75% of value. And as we know, in Europe and the States, a lot of the banks are trading somewhere between 30 and 50%. I think that, you know, in Israel, there was not a banking crisis in 2008. There wasn't a housing crisis. And these are obviously the two main areas which are going to affect the financials. I think if we dropped towards 50% valuations, which are the lows that we've seen over the last decade in 2001, 2002, and in 2008 as well, then there would be some reason for concern.
Neil, overall, what percentage of a chance do you think that the world will actually fall back into recession? And how much would that shade off GDP growth in Israel?
Well, unfortunately, I'm not a prophet and I'm not in the business of prophesizing that. But I would say one thing. Our governor, Professor Stanley Fisher, as you know, last week decided to cut interest rates, once again being ahead of the curve, once again being one of the first in the world to do that. And if you have a look generally at the Israeli economy, you can see that growth is still between 4 and 5%. Inflation is still somewhere in the midpoint of the curve. So really, the only reason is, it seems to us, the view of the Bank of Israel that world growth is going to slow quite dramatically. And he's looking, and he has looked, to preempt.
Neil, thank you. Neil Corney, treasurer of Citibank Israel, joining us live there from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange.